Let's talk about point-to-point and point-to-multipoint connections in UniFi. So a little while ago, Ubiquiti came out with a couple of new devices. I'm talking about the DeviceBridge Pro and the DeviceBridge Pro-Sector. In this video, we're going to take a look at both of those devices. We're going to talk about how they can be used to extend your network wirelessly over long distances. Now, this is especially important if you've got a detached garage or an outbuilding or a remote gatehouse or something where you want the network to extend for a security camera or just for network connectivity, but you don't have an ability to run a wire. So we'll cover everything that you need to know about these devices and hopefully answer any questions that you may have. Now we've got a lot to cover, so let's get started. Okay, let's start by popping over into the Ubiquiti store. And to get to this page here, you can go to Wi-Fi and then you can click on bridging. Now, the device bridge, I did a full video on that. You can go check it out. We're talking about the device bridge pro and the device bridge pro sector, these first two that you can see right here. Now, listed on this page is also the building bridge XG and the building bridge. Those are more expensive point-to-point only products that operate in the 60 gigahertz wireless spectrum. Those are different than the ones that we're talking about because these are in the 5 gigahertz wireless spectrum. The difference there being that 60 gigahertz is going to provide you much faster speeds at much reduced distances. Whereas I find that 5 gigahertz stuff is pretty much good for any sort of remote network connectivity, unless you absolutely need like gigabit plus connectivity to the remote side. The 5 gigahertz ones are also much less expensive, as you can see here. Now, these two products are the same price, $199 for either the DeviceBridge Pro Sector or the DeviceBridge Pro. The difference here is that the DeviceBridge Pro, that's this one that I've got behind me right here. So the DeviceBridge Pro can function as a point-to-point if you have two of these. So you can have one of these on one side, one of these on the other side, and they can create a point-to-point link between them. Or this can function as the child side of a point-to-multipoint connection, with the DeviceBridge Pro Sector being the parent side of that connection. So in the wireless ISP world, typically, we think of these two sides as access point side. That's basically the side where the larger network lives, and then the station side, which is the remote side. So in the example of a point to multipoint network, the point to multipoint access point would be the access point side, and then all of the various remote devices that are connecting in to that point to multipoint access point are the station side of that connection. Now, for this UniFi equipment, Ubiquiti has simplified that down a little bit. They're using the terminology parent and child instead, which actually makes a lot of sense, and I kind of like that they did that. So, parent would be the access point side, child would be the station side, but for the rest of the video, I'm just going to be referring to these as a parent and child. So if we look at the DeviceBridge Pro Sector, that can essentially be a parent device to up to 50 remote child access points. And the remote child access points can be this DeviceBridge Pro. Now, each of these devices are fully made to be directly out in the elements. This one, for example, is IPX6 weatherproof. Here we can see it's a 2x2 MIMO 5 gigahertz radio at 17 dBi. Now, this is also a 90 degree sector. In fact, I've got it right over here. So let's take a look at this device. Turn on the light here. So this is the DeviceBridge Pro Sector, and you can see it has this sort of concave thing right here. That is a 90 degree sector antenna. So any of the child UDB Pros that you're going to connect into this parent device have to be within this 90 degree sort of slice of pie that comes off of the front of this thing. Okay, so let's now take a look at how this device looks within UniFi. So let's go to UniFi, And here we can see in my UniFi network here at my remote office, I have a UDB-Pro-Sector and I already have a single UDB-Pro set up. So we're gonna see that one in just a second, but let's start by clicking on this UDB-Pro-Sector. Here we can see that it's connected. I can see the parent switch device and I can see right now it has one child, although it's definitely not at 984 feet. It's just across my office here, maybe about 20, 25 feet. And then if we click over on settings, we can change the name, we can set the channel width, we can set the channel manually if we want to make sure that there's no interference with other devices in the area, and we can give it a static IP. That's about it, right? There's really not a lot to these devices. Now, if we close that out and come over here to the UDB Pro, here we can see that it's connected to the UDB Pro sector. We can see that it's got a really good signal strength. And again, if we click on settings, there's really not much that we can do here, although I can mesh it to my U6 Pro access point instead of the UDB Pro sector. Of course, that would be a mesh connection, not a point-to-multipoint connection. But I've also got a camera running off of this other device. So this is kind of one of the main use cases for these devices is to get a secondary access point or some PoE powered device like a surveillance camera on the remote side. So imagine you've got a workshop, you know, separated from your house, and you want to put a camera out in that workshop. This is a pretty easy way to do it. So let's take a look at the other side of that link. And so this is the UDB Pro, and you can't really see because I've got the PoE injector down low, but this is not plugged into the network. This is only receiving its internet connection, its network connection, through the point-to-point connection with the UDB Pro sector. Now, also plugged into this device, I have a G4 or G5 bullet camera, whatever this is, and this is powered up with PoE off of the secondary Ethernet port of this device. Now, while I'm using this for a surveillance camera, you could also very easily instead use this for a secondary access point. So say you had a detached garage. You put this on the outside of the garage connecting to the UDB Pro sector or another one of these UDB Pros that's at your main house. And then you can string up an access point to provide wireless connectivity to clients inside the garage. And really, there's not much more to these devices than that, except there is one interesting caveat when you're setting these things up or adopting them for the first time. And I'm going to show you that with a second UDB Pro that I have here. We're going to take it out of the box. This is brand new, never been used. And these do come with a PoE injector, by the way, I should mention. So that's actually kind of a nice touch. The one caveat that you need to know about these devices, right? So this UDB Pro can be either a parent access point for a parent-to-child point-to-point connection, or it can be a child access point to a child-to-parent point-to-multipoint setup like I've got here in my office, right? Where you're connecting to one of these UDB sectors. The difference, and you saw that there's not a lot of configuration that you can do with these things in UniFi. So how do you determine whether it's going to be a parent device or a child device? And the way you determine that is you either plug it into the network when you initially adopt it or not. So basically, if I have my PoE injector and one side of this PoE injector is going to power up this device, the other Ethernet port on this PoE injector can be plugged into the network to receive a network connection or not. Now, if it is not plugged in to receive a network connection, it's going to assume that you want this device to be the child device of a separate parent device. Hopefully that makes sense, because you might have multiple point-to-multipoint networks happening in your network, right? So that's the only difference that you really need to be aware of. If you want this to be a child device of a parent that is already on the network, you just need to plug this in and generally point it at that parent device, and it should pick it up ready for adoption. So let's go ahead and do that now. You gotta find a spot where, all right, so I don't really have a good spot for this, but we'll try it. All right, so I got a 3 meter network cable here. Okay, we're gonna get down here because I don't actually wanna clamp it on here. All right, so I'm plugging this into the PoE inside of this device. I'm just going to sort of point it towards the parent device like so. And then we've got the PoE injector right here. I'm going to plug that in. And now we can see a white light, so it has power. And we're going to plug this into the power side of the PoE injector. Now, what this means is this device now has power, but it's not connected to my network at all. So what should happen here is it should just show up in UniFi ready for adoption, assuming that it's going to connect to the UDB-Pro-Sector as its parent device. Let's go head back to UniFi. All right, get my mood lighting dialed in again. Let's go to the desktop here, and hopefully we should see this thing pop in just a moment. In fact, while we're waiting, I'm going to rename the old one UDB Pro 1 so that we know that it's the first one of two. And now we wait for the second one. Okay, there we go. So now we see a second UDB Pro, keeping in mind that this device is not plugged into my network. It's only plugged into power, but here we can see it ready to adopt. So let's go ahead and click to adopt. And it says UDB Pro will be adopted as a child device to the UDB Pro sector. To set it up as a parent device, this is what I was telling you about, connect it via a cable and then adopt it. So we're gonna say, okay, we wanna confirm. We are adopting it as a child device to the parent sector antenna. The new UDB Pro has finished adopting, and then I ran it through the updates to get it on the latest firmware. And now we can see that this device, I'll name it UDB Pro 2, is connected and working, and it says that it is meshing to the UDB Pro sector, albeit it doesn't have quite as good a signal as the other one, considering I didn't align it or anything, I just plopped it on the floor. Now, while that device was being adopted, I took an Ethernet cable, I plugged it into the secondary port of that brand new UDB Pro, and then I plugged it into my laptop here that's on the side of my desk. So from this laptop, this does not have any wired connect or wireless connection to any of the networking in here. It's only connected through the remote side of that now UDB Pro to UDB Pro sector parent-child relationship. We can see that we do have internet connectivity. I can ping out. And let's also run a speed test. And we can see that in this speed test, I'm getting close to 200 megabits per second across that link. And of course, if it weren't just sitting on the floor, if it were actually properly aligned, I would expect that to be a little bit higher, probably somewhere between 250 to 350 megabits. All right, there we go. We ended up with 157 by 217. Not bad for just plugging it in and adopting it. I was editing that portion of the video and I realized that you guys are probably not gonna be happy with that single speed test result. You know, a decade of being on YouTube has given me this spidey sense for what people are gonna like and not like down in the comments. So we're gonna run a couple more tests. Pardon the cable mess of spaghetti down here, but that is the test that I ran previously, and that is shooting all the way over to the other side of my office right here. It's about 20, 25 feet, but this one is obviously not properly aligned because it's just sitting on the floor and it's kind of pointing up towards the ceiling. But this one more or less is properly aligned, and it's, you know, a little bit higher and it's pointing directly at the UDB Pro sector parent access point. So I took the secondary Ethernet out of this device and I have it plugged directly into the laptop. Let's run a couple more speed tests. From my laptop, once again, we're gonna start with an internet speed test out to speedtest.net and we're gonna say go. And we ended up with 248 by 179, which is more or less what I would expect when testing a 5 gigahertz link like this. Typically, you're going to see speeds between, you know, 250 up to perhaps 350 if the conditions are absolutely ideal. And that's more than enough bandwidth for extending your network out to another location where you just have a couple of security cameras or a wireless access point. 250 megabits is pretty decent. But let's also see if there's any difference when we're testing across the local area network. So I've set up Open Speed Test Server on my main computer here and bringing it up on my laptop, we're gonna say start. And we ended up with 280 down by 186 up. Again, falls right in line with what I would expect out of this type of 5 gigahertz point to multipoint link. All right, there you go. A quick look at the new UDB-Pro and UDB-Pro-Sector antennas for point-to-point or point-to-multipoint connectivity managed through UniFi. And now these devices say that they can transmit their signal up to 5 kilometers. I have not tested them at any distances anywhere close to that. However, if you have experience with these devices, especially at longer distances, put that down in the comments below, as I'm sure people will love to see that information. And remember, if you have any trouble or want help designing a point-to-point or point-to-multipoint setup for your own environment, your own network, that's what Rogue Support is for. We specialize in design, configuration, and troubleshooting of all things networking and wireless. All right, hope you guys enjoyed this video, and we'll see you in the next one.